Adjutant, online. Receiving incoming transmission. Greetings, Commander. Welcome to International Space Station. Current planetary situation report. Warning, potential cataclysmic events noted. Multiple extinction level hazards detected. Mission update, create additional human colonies at safe distance from Terra Prime. Searching for viable planets. Viable planet for human colonization found. Technological viability analysis of colonization of Mars in process. Viable technology for Mars colonization found. Processing technology analysis. The SpaceX Starship system is a fully reusable two-stage-to-orbit super heavy lift launch vehicle under development by SpaceX since 2012 as a self-funded private spaceflight project. The second stage, which is also referred to as Starship, is being designed as a long-duration cargo and eventually passenger-carrying spacecraft. It is being used initially without any booster stage at all as part of an extensive development program to prove out launch and landing and iterate on a variety of design details, particularly with respect to the vehicle's atmospheric re-entry. While the spacecraft is currently being tested on its own at suborbital altitudes, it will later be used on orbital launches with an additional booster stage. The Super Heavy, where the spacecraft will serve as both the second stage on the two-stage-to-orbit launch vehicle and the in-space long-duration orbital spaceship. Integrated system testing of a proof of concept for Starship began in March 2019. With the addition of a single Raptor rocket engine to a reduced-height prototype nicknamed Starhopper, similar to Grasshopper, an equivalent prototype of the Falcon 9 reusable booster. Starhopper was used from April through August 2019 for static testing and low-altitude, low-velocity flight testing of vertical launches and landings in July and August 2019. More prototype Starships have been built and more are under construction as the iterative design goes through several iterations. All test articles have a 9 meters diameter stainless steel hull. SpaceX could potentially launch commercial payloads using Starship no earlier than 2021. In April 2020, NASA selected a modified crew-rated Starship system as one of three potential lunar landing system design concepts to receive funding for a 10-month-long initial design phase for the NASA Artemis program. While the name of the vehicle has changed many times over the years, the combination of Starship spacecraft and Super Heavy booster is called the Starship system by SpaceX in their payload user's guide. Sometimes, as on the SpaceX website, the term Starship is used as a collective term for both the Starship spacecraft and the Super Heavy booster. At least as early as 2005, SpaceX used the codename BFR for a conceptual heavy lift vehicle far larger than the Falcon family of vehicles with a goal of 110 tons to orbit. Beginning in mid-2013, SpaceX referred to both the mission architecture and the vehicle as the Mars Colonial Transporter. By the time a large 12-meter diameter design concept was unveiled in September 2016, SpaceX had begun referring to the overall system as the Interplanetary Transport System. With the announcement of a new 9-meter design in September 2017, SpaceX resumed referring to the vehicle as BFR. Elon Musk said, in the announcement, "We are searching for the right name, but the code name, at least, is BFR. SpaceX President Gwynne Shotwell subsequently stated that BFR stands for Big Falcon Rocket. In November 2018, the spaceship was renamed Starship, and the first stage booster was named Super Heavy. Super Heavy, the booster stage, needed to escape Earth's deep gravity well, is expected to be 72 meters long and 9 meters in diameter, with a gross liftoff mass of 3,680,000 kilograms. It is to be constructed of stainless steel tanks and structure holding subcooled liquid methane and liquid oxygen propellants powered by 28 Raptor rocket engines that will provide 72,000 kilonewtons of total liftoff thrust. The specification propellant capacity of Super Heavy was shown as 3,400,000 kilograms in May 2020. 3% more than estimated in September 2019. The initial prototype, Super Heavy, will be full size. It is expected, however, to initially fly with less than the full complement of 28 engines. Perhaps approximately 20. The Super Heavy external design changed throughout 2019-2020 as the detailed design was iterated and the Raptor engines were tested and achieved higher power levels. In September 2019, a design change for the booster stage to have 6 fins that serve exclusively as fairings to cover the 6 landing legs and 4 diamond-shaped welded steel grid fins to provide aerodynamic control on descent was discussed. In August 2020, as the first build of Booster Prototype 1 was to get underway, Elon Musk noted that the leg design had been modified to just 4 landing legs and fins to improve supersonic engine plume recirculation margins. As of September 2019, the Starship upper stage is expected to be a 9-meter diameter and 50-meter tall, fully reusable spacecraft with a dry mass of 120 tons. Powered by 6 methane-oxygen propellant Raptor engines, 3 of them will be for use at sea level, while the other 3 would be used for vacuum burns. Total Starship thrust will be approximately 11,500 kilonewtons. Unusual for previous launch vehicle and spacecraft designs, the upper stage of Starship is intended to function both as a second stage to reach orbital velocity on launches from Earth and also be used in outer space as an on-orbit long-duration spacecraft. Starship is being designed so as to be capable of re-entering Earth's atmosphere from orbital velocities and landing vertically, with a design goal of rapid reusability. Starship will use 3 sea-level optimized Raptor engines and 3 vacuum optimized Raptor engines. These sea-level engines are identical to the engines on the Super Heavy booster. Transport use in space is expected to use a vacuum optimized Raptor engine variant to optimize specific impulse to approximately 3.7 kilometers per second. Starship is planned to eventually be built in at least these operational variants. Spaceship, a large, long-duration spacecraft capable of carrying passengers or cargo to interplanetary destinations, to low Earth orbit, or Earth-to-Earth spaceflight. Satellite delivery spacecraft, a vehicle able to transport and place spacecraft into orbit or handle the in-space recovery of spacecraft and space debris for return to Earth or movement to another orbit. In the March 2020 user's guide, this was shown with a large cargo bay door that can open in space to facilitate delivery and pickup of cargo. Tanker, a cargo-only propellant tanker to support the refilling of propellants in Earth orbit. The tanker will enable launching a heavy spacecraft to interplanetary space, as the spacecraft being refueled can use its tanks twice, first to reach low Earth orbit and afterwards to leave Earth orbit. The tanker variant, also required for high-payload lunar flights, is expected to come only later. Initial in-space propellant transfer will be from one standard Starship to another. Lunar surface-to-orbit transport, a variant of Starship without air brakes or heat shielding that is required for in-atmosphere operations. Additionally, the ship will be equipped with a docking port on the nose and have white paint as opposed to the bare steel planned for regular Starships. On 30 April 2020, NASA selected SpaceX to develop a human-rated lunar lander for the Artemis program, therefore requiring SpaceX to develop an approach for a direct lunar landing. Characteristics of Starship are to include the following: ability to re-enter Earth's atmosphere and retro-propulsively land on a designated landing pad. Landing reliability is projected by SpaceX to ultimately be able to achieve airline levels of safety due to engine out capability. Rapid reusability without the need for extensive refurbishment. Automated rendezvous and docking operations. On-orbit propellant transfers between Starships. Ability to reach the Moon and Mars after on-orbit propellant loading. stainless steel structure, and tank construction. Its strength to mass ratio should be comparable to or better than the earlier SpaceX design alternative of carbon fiber composites across the anticipated temperature ranges from the low temperatures of cryogenic propellants to the high temperatures of atmospheric reentry. Some parts of the craft will be built with a stainless steel alloy that has undergone cryogenic treatment in which metals are cold formed to produce a cryo-treated steel. Dramatically lighter and more wear-resistant than traditional hot-rolled steel. Methane and oxygen gas pressure-fed hot gas reaction control system thrusters for attitude control, including the final pre-landing pitch-up maneuver from belly flop to tail down, and stability during high wind landings up to 60 km per hour. Initial prototypes are using nitrogen cold gas thrusters, which are substantially less mass efficient, but are expedient for quick building to support early prototype flight testing. A thermal protection system against the harsh conditions of atmospheric reentry. This will include ceramic tiles after earlier evaluating a double stainless steel skin with active coolant flowing in between the two layers or with some areas additionally containing multiple small pores that will allow for transpiration cooling. Options under study included hexagonal ceramic tiles that could be used on the windward side of Starship. A novel atmospheric reentry approach for planets with atmospheres, while retro propulsion is intended to be used for the final landing maneuver on the Earth, Moon, or Mars, 99.9% of the energy dissipation on Earth reentry is to be removed aerodynamically, and on Mars, 99% aerodynamically, even using the much thinner Martian atmosphere, where body flaps are used to control attitude during descent and optimize both trajectory and energy dissipation during descent. As envisioned in the 2017 design unveiling, the Starship is to have a pressurized volume of approximately 825 cubic meters, which could be configured for up to 40 cabins, large common areas, central storage, a galley, and a solar flare shelter for Mars missions. Flexible design options, for example, a possible design modification to the base Starship, expendable three-engine Starship, with no fairing, rear fins, nor landing legs, in order to optimize its mass ratio for interplanetary exploration with robotic probes. According to Elon Musk, when Starship is used for beyond Earth orbit launches to Mars, the functioning of the overall expedition system will necessarily include propellant production on the Mars surface. He says that this is necessary for the return trip and to reuse the spaceship to keep costs as low as possible. He also says that lunar destinations, circumlunar flybys, orbits and landings will be possible without lunar propellant depots so long as the spaceship is refueled in a high elliptical orbit before the lunar transit begins. Some lunar flybys will be possible without orbital refueling, as evidenced by the mission profile of the Dear Moon project. The SpaceX approach is to tackle the hardest problems first, and Elon Musk sees the hardest problem for getting to sustainable human civilization on Mars to be building a fully reusable orbital Starship, so that is the major focus of SpaceX resources as of 2020. For example, it is planned for the spacecraft to eventually incorporate life support systems, but as of September 2019, Elon Musk has stated that it is yet to be developed, as the early flights will all be cargo only. Starship Human Landing System for Artemis Program. A modified version, known as the Starship Human Landing System, was selected by NASA in April 2020 for potential use for long-duration crewed lunar landings as part of NASA's Artemis program. This Starship variant is being designed to stay on and around the Moon, and as such, both the heat shield and air brakes, which are integral parts of the main Starship design, are not included in this Starship design. The variant will use high-thrust methane, oxygen, RCS thrusters, located mid-body, on Starship during the final tens of meters of the terminal lunar descent and landing, and will also include a smaller crew area and a much larger cargo bay. It will be powered by a solar array located on its nose below the docking port. SpaceX intends to use the same high-thrust RCS thrusters for liftoff from the lunar surface. If built, this variant would be launched to Earth orbit via the Super Heavy booster and would use orbital refueling to reload propellants into Starship for the lunar transit and lunar landing operations. In the 2020 mission concept, a NASA Orion spacecraft would carry a NASA crew to the lander, where they would depart and descend to the surface in Starship. After lunar surface operations, it would ascend, using the same Starship vehicle, and return the crew to the Orion. Although not confirmed yet, the vehicle in theory could be refueled in orbit to carry more crews and cargo to the surface. SpaceX is one of three organizations developing their lunar lander designs for the Artemis program over a 10-month period in 2020 to 2021. If SpaceX completes the milestone-based requirements of the design contract, then NASA will pay SpaceX $135 million in design development funding. The other teams selected are the national team, led by Blue Origin, but including Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, and Draper, with $579 million in design funding, and Dynetics, with SNC and other unspecified companies, with $253 million in NASA funding. At the end of the 10-month program, NASA will evaluate which contractors will be offered contracts for initial demonstration missions and select firms for development and maturation of lunar lander systems. Several high-altitude prototypes, SN8 to SN14, are undergoing testing or are under construction. SN8 has passed cryogenic tests, preburner, and static fire tests, and nose cone mate. A flight of SN8 to an altitude of 12.5 kilometers is planned for December 8, 2020.